literally
taken.
Taken. Money, body, taken. But Paul writes in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse number 8, that prophecies shall be done away with.
All right.
Tongues shall cease. And the gift of knowledge shall vanish.
All right.
Thus, it is evident from our churches that many of the gifts listed in 1 Corinthians chapter 12 is no longer with us.
All right. All right.
All right.
And so I hear you wondering why.
Why?
Well, only God really knows.
All right.
When they were prevalent, brothers and sisters, they still was only given to a few and not all the churches.
Amen.
They was never given to all the believers.
All right.
But what is important, brothers and sisters, is not the gift of tongues. What is important to God is that men and women receive salvation through Jesus Christ.
All right.
So let me back up again. Even though tongues is mentioned in the New Testament, it becomes evident of the outpouring of the Holy Ghost. Yeah, we no longer believe that God is still giving the gifts of tongue,
right,
just like we no longer believe he's giving the gift of prophecy.
All
because
right,
there's no need to give the gift of prophecy, because the Revelation is the final book of prophecy.
All right.
And all we need, since we have the final book of prophecy, is somebody to interpret, somebody to clarify, somebody to explain what the prophecies are saying. In the story of Cornelius, when the Bible talks about that they spoke in tongues, magnified God as a result of the pouring out of the Holy Ghost, what it's really doing there is drawing parallel.
All right.
Between what happens on the day of Pentecost with the Jewish Christians.
All right.
And what happens in the house. I wish I could help somebody.
All right.
On the day of Pentecost, when the Holy Ghost came, and they was all in the upper room. They were Jewish.
All right.
Yeah. And when the Holy Ghost comes upon them, they began to speak in other tongues.
Right.
Now, the only way the Jewish Christians are going to accept the Gentile Christians is that they must have testimony that the Gentile Christian will experience something similar to what they experienced.
All right.
And so God, because he foreknew, pours out the Holy Ghost, which causes them to speak in tongues in the house of Cornelius.
All right.
All right.
All right.
So that's what it's there for.
All right.
That's what it's
there
for.
For. I'm not trying to knock nobody.
All right.
All right.
That believe they have the gift of tongues. That's their business.
All right.
All right.
What I'm telling you is that according to the scripture,
all right,
the tongues is no longer necessary.
All right. All right.
What is necessary is faith.
Amen.
Can I tell you that?
All right.
I'm going to tell you a story, and then I got to get out of here with a story.
All right.
That was a rich man who had everything.
All right.
And a beggar named Lazarus.
All right.
All right. All right, tell it.
Both of them died.
All right.
All right.
The beggar ended up in Lazarus, in Abraham's arms.
All right.
The rich man lifted up his eyes hell.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
And it was so hot in hell.
Oh, yeah.
That he said, Father Abraham.
Oh, yeah.
Send Lazarus that he might dip his finger in a cool water and put it on my tongue and cool my tongue.
All right.
Yeah, and the message was given to him, there's a great gulf. Lazarus can't come.
That's right.
He can't come. And what the rich man said, well, why don't somebody
all right,
who has died
all right,
go back to earth.
That's right.
And tell my brothers, what a terrible place
that's right,
this is.
All right.
Are y'all with me still?
Amen.
And the message was given to him. If they don't believe the preachers and the prophets that's right, already there.
All right.
They're not going to believe someone coming back. I wish I could help somebody here. And what I'm trying to get you to see is that if all of the preaching that we do not lead folks to salvation,
amen,
come, set them up.
All right.
All right.
All right.
That's right.
Did you hear what I said?
Amen.
Because we do enough preaching to say everybody, including the dog, the cat, the squirrel, the bear,
all right,
and the chiquito.
All right.
All right.
So if they won't accept the preaching of the gospel, what effect do tongues have?
All right.
That's right.
Come on, talk to me, somebody.
All right.
You can talk in tongues, but that's what you got your own crib for.
That's right.
All right.
In your dungeon.
Shout it in your house.
In your dungeon. Behind your wall.
Cornelius here. Can I go now?
Yes, sir. Come on.
Lord have mercy.
Come on. Come on. Come on.
Cornelius can receive the gift. The Holy Ghost.
All right.
And the tongues suggested to those who were Jewish that the law had accepted the Gentile. Did you hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I'm gonna leave you with one final thing from Cornelius.
All right.
Because I told you that Cornelius was a man who believed in God.
All right.
I told you that Cornelius was a man who believed in prayer. And I told you that Cornelius was a man who believed in helping somebody.
All right.
Did not tell you that, but that doesn't get you into heaven. Did you hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Nice guys don't go to heaven. Did you hear what I'm saying?
All right.
I said, nice guys don't go to heaven.
All right.
I wish I had a witness here. I said, nice guys don't go to heaven.
Man.
But in order to get to heaven, you got to believe in God's Son. Do I have a witness here? So wise for you heard the preaching of the gospel. Accepted the Lord Jesus. Can I tell you that?
Yeah.
And those that was in his household, his family, and his friends, they accepted the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Right.
Did you hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So let me leave you when I tell you that Cornelius is really us. Did you hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.